having all these technologies has really changed the way in which people think about commerce, communication, and communities. At one point, commerce was essentially based on a seller trying to find the right buyer on a one-on-one basis and making the best deal possible. But today, a lot of what has happened is that commerce has now been transformed from being dyadic relationships between a buyer and a seller to being a scenario where what you're dealing with is a community of potential buyers. And the goal of commerce today is to make a website as a host of that community so that people come to the website not just to buy a product, but to meet like-minded people, to be able to share with them ideas about these products, to be able to have suggestions on how to make the products better, as well as to learn from one another about what happens in the future of that particular product. So a perfect example of this is a company called Cisco that makes a lot of network devices. And what they found was that in their case, they had several people who were system administrators and network administrators who were using Cisco routers in their various offices. And rather than having to buy and sell products directly to individuals, they created a website where all of these network administrators would form a community where they would trade ideas with one another and help one another with troubleshooting problems with the network routers that Cisco was selling. And Cisco could then focus on the fact that they had free access to a large number of customers, loyal customers, who would give them ideas on what should be the next generation of products, what were the specific features that these products would have. And it all happened because what they focused on was not selling specific products to a